Boss.
The first thing I must say is that I number one take issue with the having flouted the COVID rules on Friday. I was outside my home after 9, and that is against the rules. It is regrettable, but all of us make mistakes. Thereafter, of course, I was brought here by a huge content in the room for the home, and I was not charged with it. They asked me to do it. I will abide by the law. No one is above the law, I'm not above the law. I have paid cash bill here, and I will be appearing in court tomorrow. And the entire course of the law will be followed. Fined, jail. I think the law applies to me like any other thing. And so, in that aspect, I do take responsibility. And indeed, I want to urge Kenyans to follow the government's guidance. I think it applies to all of us. The disease doesn't know any station or any political office. What is surprising was everything else apart from that. And as I said, I will bear responsibility for the legal issues. But the fact that the whole of Saturday and Sunday, more than 50 officers brandishing guns have been going to my residence. I'm not a fugitive. My children have not committed any crime. Why come intimidate them with guns? 50 officers. I am not on the run. I called Ndolo, I told him, if you want me to appear, I'm a leader, I'll appear. My firstborn son is 8 years old. My secondborn son is 6 years old, turning 7. My daughter is a year old. Why send 50 officers, 5 times? Why stake out outside my house to capture me, to keep me here for the weekend? So if it's anything else, I am ready to deal with anything. But on flouting the rules, I apologize to Kenya, and I will pay the full consequence of the law. I also wish to state that I resigned from the ad hoc committee on COVID, which I've been chairing. We have done a lot of work so far. I support the work that the government is doing and the officers. I think they're doing a good job across the country. But because of that responsibility and the example that I need to set, I have this morning officially about that. So I think let me leave it at that for now. Unless anyone has any questions.
Yes, a question. Perhaps to Mr. Lefnum, in what capacity are you here? Is this lawyer or as a friend?
That question is almost rhetorical. But I agreed, and after speaking to my good friend, accompanied him here both as a lawyer and a colleague, and because he gave me that undertaking that he's willing to provide for the law, and we will come report the different or appear, because the sentiment over the weekend and this morning that he was running away or disappear or something that we needed to debunk this morning. Because the people who were running that agenda wanted Sakaja to be handcuffed, brought here, I think, to himself. That's the reason we individually agreed, both as his friend and a good lawyer in Kenya, to come here to accompany him for the purposes of understanding what is exactly transpired at that place to Saturday morning.
Senator Lambda, I'm Kaimba from Ebro TV. Senator Sakaja, inasemekana kwamba wakati wa hiyo siku polisi wanasema ulizua vurugu baada ya kupiga hiyo kitu, na hata ukawatishia kwamba wafuta kazi.
Lakini vanijua dalili alizomekaka atishia mtu, sina nguvu ya kutoka mtu kazi ama kutoka mtu. Ni ile mambo ingine ambayo iliendelea ndio ilionyesha ni mambo ingine. Yani hadi hata kupigwa ngumi mimi. It was just about being out of the line, but it wanted. So ni sawa. Kweli yote itatoka. But nafikiri vile nimesema ya kwamba sote tuwe wote maagizo. Mimi ni binadamu kama mtu yote mwingine kama wewe. Hakuna mtu ambaye ni malaika. I'm not an angel. I'm law abiding. Sijai pelekwa kotini na kesi ingine yoyote. Sijai ba shilingi moja ya Mkenya. Sijai amjai sikia skandoli yote. Teleza tu. But hiyo sasa kuharas familia yangu, watu wangu. Keep the officers, you don't need to keep the officers for rest. So hiyo ingine pia hiyo tuko nayo. Ya kuenda kotini kesho, ndaenda kama Mkenya yoyote. Kusalimisha. But hiyo narrative ingine, kwanza kusema zibu dead is down. There's no place called dead is down. Leo wanataka kikae ni kama nilikuwa chibu nafaya ni. Hakuna mali inaitwa hivu. That place is along the street where I live, you know. But I think sisi ni viongozi, sisi ni wa Kenya. And with the advice of my lawyers and everybody else. Na shukuru wala wamekua na wasiwasi wananigiza mambo. Mambo yuko sawa. Whatever else it is, because hata wale officers walikuja subaru tano usiku. Wale walikuja, kuna mambo walisema. Kwa nini walikuwa wanafanya hivyo, itajitokeza. Na I think mtaisikia. Kwa sasa, wacha niachie hapo tafadhali. I have said I will present myself. I've asked to be shown what I've been charged with. I'm saying violation of curfew orders. And I'm saying here it is true. I went against that. I'm not trying to make an excuse. The many times, even when I'm oversighting, I move around. I have to go around the city and see. But I can say on Friday, it was not any official duty. I was not oversighting, I was not looking at what they're doing. I was on the wrong, and I'm sorry for that. But the other thing is that around it, we shall deal with anything else. Then I'm going to go to Kamati. But then left for many of the cars, what when I hope it, not working. Asante.
Kunjema.
Kunjema.
Tandeni, kukukuja, kwa
hini. Alibeni ya mbukumu.